Well, we started, there was a kind of hardcore scene in Chicago, and we were all either in bands or going to see bands. And Joe and Pete, our bass player, were talking about doing some kind of more melodic band.
Yeah. Like essentially, like Pete was doing a hardcore band. Andy was in it for a bit a while ago. I did it for a little bit, and then I was kind of trying to do this other thing. And he was kind of getting a little disenchanted with doing a hardcore band. And I was like, "You want to come up? Let's do a popular band." And I was like, "Dude, it'd be fun to do a popular band."
It wasn't until we were recording "Take This to Your Grave" that it was solidified that it was going to be the four of us, because I was not playing guitar and he was not playing drums in the band yet. And then we just kind of happened upon the lineup, and we toured for a long time in a broken down van. It was kind of like whatever.
It started out very small, putting up a webpage on mp3.com with demos and stuff. And even before then, like making our own mailing list where I just found people on AOL, and I would just send email addresses and just like annoy them. You know what I mean? Like, I started out like that, and then
before we had a record out, there's no way we really could have survived touring if it wasn't for the internet, because there are people that would come to our shows and know our songs, know the words, etc. But had, you know, we didn't have a record, we didn't have anything, we didn't even, you know, we were selling shirts at shows, and that was it.
Pretty much the only thing that's keeping us alive was like file sharing.
Yeah, so it was very cool early on. It gave us that much, like, you know, that much more an identity than just some band that's coming through town. You know what I mean? In some little basement club, there were like people that would come and see us. So we're a band, and we're a band because we're a band. You know what I mean? We're a band because that's what we do. That's what we know how to do. And anything else is kind of superficial. Is kind of extra.
Superfluous.
Superfluous. Thanks for
that's the right word.
Copious.
Well, that means plentiful.
Well, both work. Thank you. Quincy Jones had a saying about, and I don't remember his exact wording. It was much better than mine will be, but that if you feel something when you're writing it, and you're worth your salt, you know that there's going to be somebody else that feels it the same way you do, you know what I mean? So don't worry about making something for people to feel. Make something for you to feel, because there's someone else like it, you know what I mean? And so that's kind of how we operate as a band, is just enjoying ourselves and touching each other's microphones.
I'm helping him realign the hand configuration. You listen to a record, and you know, you hear how it sounds, and if you like the music and you want to come see us play, I wouldn't expect it necessarily to go to the show and hear the record exactly how you hear it from your stereo. You know, we're pretty energetic live, and we like to be entertaining. Just as much as we like to be entertained, you know, we like to interact with the crowd, and the more the crowd interacts with us, you know, the more excited we get, and we're very energetic, we move around a lot. And
we're rather open about what we are. If there are flaws in it, there are flaws in it. We're gonna hit some wrong notes, but we're also gonna hit some right ones.
Yeah. We're not studio musicians, you know. I mean, like, we know that a lot of us are self-taught.
I mean, the importance is the energy of the show. That's what makes a show. That's what makes a show a show. That's why you go to a concert to see a band, is to see, you know, the mistakes and the falls and, like, you know, the things that make it different and experience.
And at the end of the day, when you go to a Fall Out Boy show, you get Fall Out Boy. You don't get, you know, anything else.
We put ourselves out there as how we are, and, you know, we give people the ability to choose whether or not to accept it.
Yeah.
I think the future is still waiting to unfold, kind of, you know? We take everything day by day. You know, you gotta play things by ear, otherwise, like, if you do too much planning and doesn't go how, like, if your expectations are too high and you do too much planning, it doesn't go as well as you plan, you're gonna be really bummed out, and it's like, why do that when you can just take every day with a grain of salt?
Right? Honestly, who cares where we are in 10 years, 5 years, next year?
And I'd love to have our fans, you know, forever, and I'd love to be there for them forever. I think we all would. You know, you can't expect anything. You know, we're today's news today, but we could be yesterday's news tomorrow. You know,
don't worry too much. That's again, don't worry about how well we're selling or whatever. Because at the end of the day, for as well as we're selling right now, there's also press that are calling us, you know, the worst band that's ever lived, or the best band that's ever lived. And you can't really pay attention to either of it because it's all too subjective to really be fact.
Yeah, you know? And that's not why we do it. I mean, everything that's happened is like, you know, absolutely blowing our minds and like is really awesome to experience. But like at the end of the day, just being able to be in a band with these guys and write music and play, whether it's to 5 people or, you know, 1 million people, like it's awesome. Either way, it's awesome. Complex, cock it and pull it.